What is up, world? Matty Beeves here. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. And this week, I'm actually not doing the intro. It's kind of weird, right? So somebody else is doing the intro. I'm going to send it over to them and we're just going to go along for the ride. I have no idea what's going on, just like you do. So this should be pretty fun, right? We're going to be watching this together. So let's go check it out and see just exactly what they got planned for us for this intro. I'll see you guys in a bit, I think.
Okay, that's a little too much. Okay, you're good.
Oh, you're going a little low there. Oh, ah.
Okay, that's enough.
Don't mind that. I was just practicing my kissing. Hello, welcome to another one of Matthew's vlogs. I'm Nelson, I'll be your host today. Listen, if you want to see more of that, there's a link in the description below. You know what? Just message me, email me, anybody. Please, I'm really alone. Okay, let's cue the music in 3, 2, 1. So it's gone. All right, guys, so I'm gonna let you in on a secret. Today we're winning our girl back. You see those flowers that I brought in the back seat? Yeah, we're gonna win this girl back, okay? Wish me luck.
I can't believe we're actually doing this. Here I go. What am I gonna say? I always get tongue twisted in these situations. Let's just do it. Oh, I'm nervous, guys. Okay, I'll play it cool. I'll be like a pizza delivery guy.
We can do a couple of those, take a couple of those and insert them, but I'm afraid it's gonna be too much. Like, you're gonna hear that all the time. Hey, how's it going?
Good. I'm doing something for Maddie's vlog.
Oh, hi, guys. Hey, vlog.
Hi. Hi. I'm sorry to disrupt, guys. Give me 1 second. Mary Jane?
Yeah.
I'm here to win you back, Mary Jane. Please.
Oh, my God.
Just take me back.
Here you go. Yeah, well, you know, how can I not take these roses?
It was a success.
Yay.
All right, guys, it was a success. I have a girlfriend now, potential wife, you know. We don't know, we don't want to rush things. But hey, if you enjoyed having me, please let Maddie know. And maybe I'll see you soon. But as of now, I'll let Maddie take over the rest of this vlog. You guys have a great day and an even better week. All right, love you guys.
All right, so welcome back. That was quite interesting. I don't know if you liked it, but I actually really enjoyed it. So thank you, Nelson, for doing the intro. I think you did a really good job, and it was good to see my family out there in LA. So thank you for including them into this week's vlog. It's always great to see my family. So for this week, I really didn't do much, unfortunately. I would have loved to have vlogged, but I didn't get a chance to. I was actually hanging out and just enjoying my free time, which I find myself doing probably a lot more than I should be doing, but that's okay. I'm only human, and it's times like these during our vlogs I actually get a chance to talk to you guys. So it kind of worked out. What I want to do is talk to you guys about how I'm a master student, or how I'm training to be a master student of cinematography. Cool. So recently I picked up 5 brand new notebooks where I can take notes on 5 cinematographers that I really, really admire and I want to learn more from. And these 5 cinematographers are Hoyte van Hoytema.
Professor, get out there and save them.
Emmanuel Lubezki.
The proper thing to do would be to finish him off quick.
He's to be cared for as long as necessary.
I understand.
Yanis Kaminski.
What's a person worth?
No. What's one worth to you?
Robert Elswit.
I have a competition in me. I want no one else to succeed.
And last but not least, Kazu Miguawa. Miguawa. I know I'm saying that wrong, but...
宿命の対決。
You know how I'm talking about. Those are the five cinematographers that I really want to learn more from. So like I've done in class or in school before, and much like you guys have done as well, I'm sure, I'm beginning to take notes on all of their movies. I'm slowly watching each cinematographer's movie one by one. So much like the rest of the world, we all watch movies, right? And we enjoy them, we love them, but I'm trying to take that experience to the next level. Because I'm a cinematographer and I'm always trying to be better at my craft, what I want to do is take notes on how the cinematographer has approached each scene. So the things that I look at, because I get a lot of people that ask me, Matt, how in the world do you take notes on these cinematographers? Or better yet, how do you take notes on movies? Well, to be truthful with you, I learned it from another cinematographer. Maybe you've heard of him, Cinematography Database, or you may know him as Matt Workman. He used to make a lot of cinematography breakdown videos, and through watching all of his videos, probably like 5 to 10 to 20 times each, I've learned how to look at a movie or look at a scene and break down the cinematography of that movie or of that scene. So essentially what I did was I trained my eye to see how a cinematographer sees a movie or sees a scene. And it's really cool and challenging at the same time to watch these movies and break down each scene that I think is interesting. So for you, you may not be a cinematographer, or you may not even be into the film industry at all, and that's okay if you want to become a master student of whatever craft it is that you enjoy. My advice to you is to get a notebook, much like this one here. Grab a notebook and take notes on whatever it is that you really enjoy. Now, you may have already went to school for something like this, or maybe you haven't had that chance to go to school and learn your craft. Well, that's okay. You don't necessarily need school for this. The best thing that you can do is just watch and observe your craft and take notes on whatever it is that you think is interesting about your craft. For example, I'll pause the movie on a specific scene and I'll check out the lighting. I'll ask myself, where does the lighting come from? And also, what about the camera movement? Is it steady? Is it handheld? Is it shaky? All those questions I ask myself when I'm looking at a frame from a movie. And what works for me is reverse engineering the scene, trying to figure out where things are coming from and what is the motivation of those things. So I think that if there's one thing you can take from this video, whether you're a filmmaker or not, and you have a craft and you have a passion and you want to learn more about it, trying to ask yourself, how did that person, how did that woman, how did that man achieve what it is that they do that you want to aspire to do as well? So just reverse engineer the entire process. And even if you don't have an answer, or even if you don't think that your answer is correct, you still should try and come up with an answer. Because most of the time I'm coming up with hypotheses on what I think the scene is constructed of. Now, whatever scene that I'm looking at and I'm observing and I'm trying to understand, I may not have the correct answer, but I do have an answer for it. So if someone were to ask me, hey Matt, could you recreate this scene? Could you recreate this look that this movie, that this scene is showing? I would be able to do that because I have an answer of how I would achieve it to get it as close as possible to that scene. Now, if you can come up with an answer of how that person achieved that specific look, or maybe achieved that engineering feat, then I think you're on the right path. Just having an answer, and it may not be the correct answer, is better than not having an answer at all. And like I said, if you can come up with an answer, I think you're on the right path, and I think that you are actively thinking of how to become a better cinematographer, or a better engineer, or a better doctor, whatever it is that you are aspiring to chase. Always have an answer and always be thinking of how that person has achieved whatever it is that you deem that you think is important. All right, so I hope that that all made sense. Just so you guys know, I'm no expert at taking notes or note taking in itself. This is something that I do because I enjoy taking notes. I enjoy studying cinematography, so I'm constantly learning how to take better notes on movies, on certain scenes. So I feel like every time I take notes, it only gets better. And I think that if you guys and girls take notes on whatever it is that you are passionate about, you're only gonna become a better student at your craft. So I hope that it all made sense. I really wanna help you guys become a better student at your craft, because I think if anyone wants to be good at something, they need to be a student beyond what your traditional school has taught you, whatever you deem or whatever you think is important. All right, so I'm gonna take a quick dinner break. Kind of hungry right now. I'm gonna be running pretty soon. So cut to the B-roll, and it's actually a really short B-roll. So I'll see you guys very soon. I think I got it.
Show them my magic.
That was really shorter than I thought it would be. But anywho, I hope you guys enjoyed this week's vlog. You know what to do if you did. Go ahead and do a super jump on that like button down below. And if you guys want to continue these conversations of how to become a master student of your craft, I would love to continue to talk about this topic. Just let me know in the comments down below. And also, before I leave, if you guys want to make the intro to next week's vlog, go ahead and just film it on your phone or your camera, whatever it is that you have nearest to you, whatever you have in your pocket, whatever's easiest to film it on. And also, if you're doing anything fun or cool or interesting this week or weekend, feel free to film it. I would love to introduce it into the vlog and just email it to me. So again, if you guys like this week's vlog, you know what to do. Go ahead and do a super jump on that like button down below, and also get subscribed to the YouTube channel, because every Wednesday is a brand new vlog. Feel free to hit that bell button as well. You will get notified whenever I post my next video. I'm Matt Abib, cinematographer, and I will see you guys in 7 days. Peace.